Starch hydrolysis test results. In order to simulate an incubator, the plates were incubated on a warming surface that allowed for a temperature of approximately 35 degrees Celsius. This time lapse allows you to observe the increase in a bacterial growth for the first 12 hours. After 24 hours, it is time to read the results. First, remove the lid from the plate. Then, take the iodine solution and put drops across the culture or flood the plate in a thin layer. When the iodine is placed on starch, it reacts with the starch. That complex will show a color change on the agar, in the range of a reddish-brown to a purplish color, depending on the composition of the iodine solution used. An interesting fact about this is that the iodine is volatile and will sublimate, become a gas. After about 15 minutes, the plate color will begin to fade. If you reapply the iodine, you will see the reaction again. If there is a change of color, the iodine is detecting the presence of starch in the agar, indicating that the bacterium did not hydrolyze the starch. This dark coloration is a negative result for starch hydrolysis. If there is no longer starch in the medium because the bacterium hydrolyzed the starch, the iodine does not react with it, and a clear area appears around the colony. A clear zone surrounding the bacterial growth is a positive result for starch hydrolysis. Now, let's check our plate to see what we have. Notice, the color developed very quickly, and there is a clear zone surrounding one of the bacterial colonies. Starch was hydrolyzed. This indicates the production of alpha amylase by this particular bacterium. This clear area is a positive result. Now, look at this other bacterium. It has color surrounding the colony. This indicates a negative result. The bacteria that were placed on the medium were E. coli and Bacillus subtilis. E. coli is amylase negative. Bacillus subtilis is amylase positive. Which of these is A, which of these is B, and which one was able to hydrolyze the starch? Record your results on the lab report.